ahead and call this finance committee meeting on February 22nd, 2016 to order at 6 p.m. Members from council, the finance committee that are present, myself, the members, Mr. Ken Hagley, Mr. Michael Zorn. President from council, Mr. Spotten, Mr. Myers, council president, the pledge, and Jason Kucinich. From the administration is Mayor Dennis Morley. It is important to note that all our directors are absent and excused for this meeting. The purpose of the meeting tonight is to discuss or have a question and answer period concerning a lease agreement with the American-Croatian Lodge. This has been referred to this committee as of last November, and it is still in committee. It has not moved forward yet. So with that, I would like to turn it over to the mayor first and have him do his thing.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I believe you're all aware of the all the items we've done in the city over the last few years due to some of our financial issues. One is the YMCA. We went to an agreement with the YMCA to run our pool, so there's no cost, to the residents of our city from their taxes. We also went into an agreement with E-Panel to run our community center for the same reason. And, you know, with the different complaints and concerns we've had about Central Park, I was approached by the lodge about taking over and putting some fields back there, and so that's where we're at. I mean, it's everyone in this room, I would imagine, knows our financials, and continue, if we can't take care of it ourselves or we can't get any initiatives passed, this is the way I thought we were going to try to go, so we have some nice things in our city. I know there's a lot of things out on social media about we're going to fence off the fields and no one's going to be allowed in. So those questions we can talk with Marco about, some other items were the fact that why don't we sell it? I guess the reasoning for my concern on trying to sell it. Yeah, we can try to sell it. We can sell it for $300,000, let's say, and by the end of the year, the $300,000 is gone. My thought process on it was, who knows, maybe in 15 years, maybe the city will have some money. Maybe our residents will pass an initiative. Maybe there's all kinds of things. For those, especially the older councilmen, I've always known, my thought on that area one day could be a senior center, a swimming pool, a community center all in one spot. Don't know if that will happen in my tenure, but that's a goal that I think the city should try to continue to have to make that as good as we can. But in the meantime, instead of it looking like it looks, I believe this would be a good thing for our city. Any questions from council?
Mr. Sir.
I have a question. I did have questions, but I got those answered. I did have a question about the new lease compared to the lease that was presented in December. Under Section 9, there was a subsection that talked about good faith effort to accommodate these soccer leagues, and I see that's been removed from the current lease. I just wanted to see if I can get an explanation why that was removed.
This is the one that I've been going on with right here.
That's the one that I used.
I'm not sure why we have the wrong cases in our mailbox tonight.
Yeah, I mean, what I did was email.
I got it on my phone.
Yeah, this is not the one that I saw. It's the one that you guys are looking at
from the emails.
From the emails is the most current.
Okay.
So I don't know why that one was put in the box, so it's not from me at least.
So this is the most current one?
Yes.
Excuse me, can I ask for clarification on that?
There will be.
Or no?
Time for public input after council has all its questions answered.
Mike, did you see?
That was what I read.
Speaking of that, though, also with soccer, I did invite Eastlake Soccer tonight, Eastlake is gonna try to, and my discussions with Marco also been, if Eastlake Soccer wanted to take it over, they have no problem paying them. But again, it comes down to the fields and fixing the fields and everything else, and no one else has come up with any money to do that.
The mayor has brought up a good point, and I think it's very relevant to the new people to be aware of this. Those fields have been empty for 2 years. We started taking a look at this back in April of trying to get a city league in there. We contacted Eastlake Boys Softball. They have no interest in reestablishing that organization. Those fields belong to them. We contacted with Eastlake Girls Softball. There was some interest there until they found out the cost to repair the fencing was between $8,000 and $10,000. Once they saw that, they walked away. I have contacted several other of the leagues in the city. None of the leagues have the financials or the time or the effort to man these fields the way they need to be properly manned. I know the mayor has also been in contact with several of them.
Did you have any more questions, Mike Wheeler?
No, I just noticed there was...
Yeah, like I said, we did ask, yeah.
Yeah, it's still in there.
Okay.
Marco, maybe you can answer some questions for the public, and the news have popped up. Fencing. Okay. How much of that do you see being fenced in, fenced off, however you want to phrase it, please?
I believe I presented a diagram to everybody that was a very rough sketch. We would have fencing on the south perimeter of the lot where it butts up into the residential housing. That would be completely fenced off. We were also looking at doing some type of fencing that would basically be a boundary from that to Washington, or the property to Washington. However, with ability of an opening and ability of a passageway, and that passageway would go to this diagram where you would have on this park type setting where we would landscape it, update it, provide a pavilion where that would be open area for everybody. And then along the side that actually bumps up into our facility would not be fenced at all. And it would be fenced to the basketball courts where they're at today, along with a short fence that would go up and around where the playground is, which would also have a gate, would open up. That's the intention. Obviously, these are rough drafts. Quotes would need to be done, architectural drawings would need. This was just a rough proposal of what we had in mind.
Okay. So where the property abuts up to the back of the community center, the 1 acre lot, the acre and 6/10 lot, whatever it is?
Are you looking at our property that's on Lakeshore?
No, I'm looking at the city property.
Okay.
That's Washington.
Yeah, that's Washington. Okay.
At the other end, there is some, you mentioned some playground equipment.
There's the playground equipment that's actually towards the community
center. Community center,
correct. That's correct. And there was some remarks on social media that I made a public statement saying the intention is not to get rid of it. The intention is to put a small short fence there and still allow that playground and keep that playground for the community center.
That clarifies that.
Yeah, we don't want to do that. In fact, if anything, we would look into upgrading it, make it nicer, cleaner, wood chips.
That answers my question. Mr. Heathley?
Just want to let you know that I have over, you know, once this all started, taken several trips over there, taken a look at the property, taken several photos. I've been in contact with the mayor. I was in contact with Marco. We did submit some questions. And some of the questions, because I'm not sure if everybody else on council were able to see everything, but some of the question was throughout the contract, it was stating as landlord. I asked who was actually the landlord, if it was it City of Eastlake or was it council, because it was going back and forth. Our law director did say that Eastlake will be in there, and that's fine. I did question in regards to the playground equipment, which we got that clarified. One of the parcels, I believe, is towards the far the western side there. Mm-hmm. It really looks like the one parcel was right against the community center, which is the 1.14. And then there's the larger one, which is the 5.74. And then the next one over is actually belonging to Willoughby Eastlake Schools. Mm-hmm. And then the next one, which is belongs to us. Are they looking at possibly, if this goes through, are we looking at flip-flopping it, or is the school's going to...
Talk to the schools. The schools will work with us, however, what we need back there, if there's any land that we need. We sat down with them and talked to them about that. Because it is weird how that is set up. You got the Board of Education, the City of Eastlake, Board of Education, Board of Education, Board of Education, Board of Education. So I don't know how that ended up being with the city parcel and all of those. We haven't gone through the auditors to take a look at that yet. Again, just for comments, too, we weren't going to have the Croatian home if this wasn't going to move anywhere. It would spend whatever it was for any architectural firms and all that. We've been talking about if the city wants to move forward on this, we will. If they don't, we won't. There's one other thing that we need cleared up. Are you done?
Well, I was letting you finish.
No, yeah. Mine's a different to clear up something else that's on the social media.
But what I was just looking at as far as that lot right there, you know, that section right there, because some of the outfield fence does go into the Willoughby Eastlake, that ball field. So if there wasn't, I just want to make sure that was going to get removed.
Yeah, the intention, obviously, we were looking at seeing if it was even feasible to flip it so that everything would be joined together and it would be one large space. And then it would obviously be properly surveyed. And then, you know, we would look at what we can use and what we can't use and upgrade and remove and install new fencing.
That was that part of it. Like I said, throughout the thing, it was just in regards to landlord, who was landlord. Randy already committed to that it would be Eastlake and not the council. Other than that, I think everything else was, we were good to go with all my other questions, and I was fine with everything.
Mr. Moore, can you clear up the social media about the 501c3 and the private American-Croatian Lodge? Because out there it's being portrayed that we are going to go doing business with a for-profit, and that's part of the reason out there for some of the issues with some of our residents. So can you clear that up?
Yeah, by all means. To a certain extent, it is true. The American-Croatian Lodge is a for-profit business. However, there are many non-profit groups that are affiliated, associated with our group that are under our umbrella. One of our groups is the Croatian Soccer Group. There's a youth and adult group. They are non-for-profit groups. They run under us. We donate a significant amount of money to them. They have basically not free rent, but discounted rent. Their coaching staff is premier coaching staff that does this on a part-time basis also. So there's no, it's not a for-profit business, that part. The lease agreement was intended to be with the lodge for a reason. The purpose is because of the financial implications that were involved. The Croatian Soccer Group doesn't have 100 to 100 or even $50,000 to invest in this kind of project. So we would do it on their behalf. They do have a lot of significant costs, which would be offsetted with this project. So essentially, we would be liable through the city of Eastlake, and I think it would actually work out in the best interest of the city of Eastlake, considering we're the ones with the asset, we're the ones with the cash, and we would be essentially sponsoring this non-for-profit group. So, I don't know if that's clear for everybody or not.
Jason?
Just follow up to that. You said they are non, you work with nonprofits. With respect to the soccer leagues or teams that would be playing there, are they all nonprofits, or is there a mixture of for-profit or
nonprofit? They're all nonprofit.
They're all nonprofit.
They're all nonprofit. There are many nonprofit organizations.
And are they C3 organizations, or do they get some other
nonprofit status? I think they're 501c3, is it? I don't know.
Do people who make contributions to them get tax deductions, which would indicate that they're a charitable organization?
I believe so. I don't know how they exactly operate. I'm not on the board of directors there, but it's my understanding that that's how it works.
Okay.
They have a membership fee as well.
Okay.
So a lot of the parents that go on there, they essentially cover 99% of the cost.
Okay. And also a follow-up to the fencing question. With respect to pedestrians and cyclists, that would be, say, cutting from the area over by Washington School to where the community center is.
Sure.
Would there be any obstructions that don't currently exist, or is there still going to be a pathway where a person could walk their dog or ride their bike through the middle?
I don't know. I mean, we're open-minded to how this is going to be designed and diagrammed. I mean, we're willing to change and work with the city of Eastlake and see what's in the best interest of everybody. If we can make a path off to the side or on one end, sure. We can try to figure something out. You know, this diagram here that's given is just, it's very rough. It's something that we were hoping to develop a rapport with. You guys are working hand in hand with you guys on this project. And obviously the risk would be on our end to be able to manage it, maintain it, or the longevity of the contract. However, the design work is very rough. We want to flip the fields or change the park a certain direction or change the path a certain ways, as long as it's within a certain scope and within a certain budget. And we can't get too lavish in make this project become a $250,000 project, because at the end of the day, you know, who's going to pay for this? It's going to be the kids and the kids' parents who are paying for this. I have to amortize the cost of this project over the longevity of the contract. So if it's 15 years, it's 15 years, plus the maintenance on a yearly basis to maintain the fields, and then I have to absorb that and essentially pass that cost on to the kids and the kids' parents. And so, we're intending, or we're hoping that the program is going to grow in order to alleviate some of that cost on an individual basis, and the lodge would obviously donate and help and maintain. So, that's the goal.
When do you anticipate starting the construction or the building of fencing or whatever that would be, and redoing the fields, I'm sure, because a lot of that field is currently in field for a baseball field? So when you plan on starting all that, is that going to be this spring?
No, we don't know. I mean, we were under the assumption that this wasn't even going to get passed. And so we have some property that's actually out in Shorten that we were looking at developing. We started drawings on that. So we have options. We're currently, we have costs right now. The program has a cost. They're actually leasing Lost Nation, and they're also going back and forth to different locations in Eastlake, and they use our fields on a temporary basis for a certain day.
And the Chardon Field is property that you own?
That is the property that the American-Croatian Lodge owns that we would actually give to our nonprofit group for them to do this on. It's 115 acres that we have it on. So, yeah. Is it 115 or 108?
Just shy of 110.
Yeah, 110 acres. So.
Do you have any concerns as far as assurances? This is a 15-year lease. I know there's a provision in there that says something like the parties can mutually agree to extend by 5 years, but I think that's kind of a superfluous provision, because of course at the end of a lease term the parties can agree to extend the lease. That's
I don't know what that means, that word that you used, I'm sorry.
Superfluous means pointless, basically.
Okay.
So, would, if, say, we were given an option for the other 5 years as opposed to just by mutual agreement of the project, would you be willing to pay something in rent for additional assurances or anything along those lines?
It's something that we would consider, sure. I have a lot of bottom line of this.
Right.
I mean, because right now this deal, we originally what we proposed was a 20-year deal because we looked at what the amount was going to be, what our current fees are for the program. 20 years made sense. Say it's not going to be any more expensive for the kids to still go ahead and play and practice. 15 years is now, it's squeezing it, and it's there's a premium now if we go in this direction. This is not exactly a great business deal on behalf of American-Croatian Lodge to be investing this kind of cash in a piece of property that isn't ours. And so it's, you know, I mean, we kind of see this as a global benefit for everybody. And at the end of the day, you know, it's all gonna matter what the dollars are going to come out to. It's just feasible for us to absorb that cost.
My next question is directed more towards the mayor. Council members who've been here a little bit longer than I have. What is the city's current expenses with respect to that area? And can you kind of break it down a little bit? I know that certainly there's going to be, you have to pay somebody to move that.
The labor's fixed. You know, we were last year we were going to close the community center down. Until we got the deal with PAL. There is no expense. Our expense here is bodies. We don't have bodies to maintain any of the fields here. And that's the bottom line. We're not going to add any bodies. I know there was also some stuff on social media about summer help. Summer help cannot be hired in the city of Eastlake while we have people laid off. Last year we tried to do summer help with the union and bring back one of their people that were laid off, and they didn't agree to that, let alone bring in outside bodies. So the summer help for cutting grass it's not in the budget this year, as you guys know, because we cannot hire unless they agree, and they're not going to agree. It's in their labor agreement, no summer help while people are laid off. People are laid off, their seniority will cut in November of this year. So next year, people can do summer help. Again, you know, I'm not going to sit here, everyone in this room knows. We have, just like for snow plowing, we have 6 people that snow plow compared to the city next to us that has 18 crews. The other city has 25 crews, so we do the best we can. Again, the complaints are that our parks look bad, and we're trying to just make them that they don't look bad. But you can't say you don't want to do something and pass them. I'll go back to 2013, the big thing when city council, we didn't open the pool. And Councilman Hayfley said, okay, let's go on the ballot. We put a ballot on, it was for $1.26 a month, and it failed. So where are the priorities from the residents? They're saying, we want it, but $1.26, we're not even going to pass. We failed 11 straight levies. As I've said in other meetings, Willoughby Eastlake Schools and Lakeland passed on a whole, but those levies failed in the city of Eastlake. So what we're trying to do is run without money and try to have things that some other cities have, and this is one of the ways. I mean, we did it with the Y, we did it with EPAL. This is what the plan is. It isn't about, like I said, it isn't about, hey, if we can sell and make $300,000 at the end of the year, you guys know we're doing the budget, we're looking at a $300,000 carryover going into 17, but again, if we sell it to them for $300,000 and it's gone forever. This way, I'm saying that we go and do this lease, and then if it reverts back to the city, the people in power then, hopefully, like I said, there is some money, and they can build and do whatever they want to do. And they're doing the enhancements. We are not.
They're saying we get the improvements.
Right. They're not going to pull the field out when it's done.
That we can't do. We don't have, that's it, we don't have the manpower. We can't hire people to do it. We haven't been able to do it. We haven't done it. That's why it looks like it does. So at the end of the 15-year lease, yeah, we can do a mutual agreement. You know, I don't know You know, if they want to go forward, maybe they don't want to go forward, maybe we won't want to go forward, but I think that leaving that open for discussion at that time would probably be appropriate. But this is, you said $250,000 investment.
We don't know.
Yeah, I know you don't know, because the last time...
We could start drawing this up, and at the end of the day, if you guys want to get elaborate on it, comes $500,000, a lot will walk away.
Nothing is ever set in stone that...
Please be recognized by the chair.
I'm sorry.
No, he might have been talking to me. Like, the last time we heard, the guy said $300,000, we were talking about a 20-year lease, but whatever it is.
Sure.
The fact is that there's nothing set in stone. If we were to, pass a levy, or, somebody wins the lottery and we get some influx of cash, because let's be frank, our ability to raise revenue here is really limited. We can always go back and revisit it. The money can always be set aside. As council, we always have the ability to say, hey, in 15 years, maybe we can do this. Maybe we could do something down at the Brucey Ballpark one of these days. Maybe if we get some kind of funding, we could turn that into a Central Park area that's just as dilapidated as Central Park. I've never even called it Central Park before. It was always the property between Washington and the community center, so I don't know where Central Park came from. But, we always have the ability to do things. We want to keep our assets that we have. If we have somebody else who's going to come in and invest in them and make our city a better place, I think we have to look long and hard at that. And in 15 years in our lifetime might seem like a very long time, but in the life of the city, it's not that long. It's not that long.
One more point before I turn it back over to you, Marco. Jason, the property, the 1-acre parcel right behind EPAL, was maintained by EPAL last year. They cut, their landscaper cut, mowed, kept that from the basketball court along the fence line, over to the far fence line. We're the ones who kept that cut, not the city. Marco, I'm sorry, go ahead. I didn't mean to interrupt you.
No, I don't think I had any other things to say. I mean, we can talk about this online. So.
Straight?
I think Ken's got something.
Oh, no, I was thinking I missed one of the questions that I did ask Marco on, and what I was questioning was, would there be any night games played, and his answer was at this time, no, they're not looking to install any kind of lights or poles, because my concern was if anything was being played at night, do we need to create some kind of buffer zones for the neighborhood around there? And that your comment was, at this time, they're not looking to do that.
Now, lighting is a huge investment. It's something that we've already looked into for our current field right now, and it's pretty significant.
And we would be looking at that more as not being an annoyance to the residents.
Sure.
So the fact that you're not interested in it, it makes it better. That makes the package more appealing.
One more question. Marco, you stated that you had some drawings going on with Chardon property?
That's correct, yeah.
Who's doing them?
Who's doing the drawings?
Yeah.
We actually had Mr. Schuster, an architect, a long time ago, start providing original drawings.
Mm-hmm.
Then there's some modified versions that were proposed to us by the nonprofit organization. I don't know who did those drawings or those diagrams exactly. There was a lot more excavating and topography being done according to their drawings. So there's a lot of different proposals, but nothing is concrete yet.
I guess my question would be, would it be possible to get some type of architectural drawing presented to this committee or to this council on the proposal for the Central Park?
I can look into it. I won't make any promises. I don't know what the cost would be. Not to provide proper architectural drawings, but topography. You're also looking at... not only just the landscaping, but the drainage, plumbing, irrigation, everything else that's going to be included in there that I'm unaware of. I mean, I don't know what the price is going to be for something that's, that we're on. We don't know if this is going to pan out. I can look into it.
That would be a big investment for you to put into that property, not knowing if you're even going to have the use of it.
Not to mention, we don't know what you guys had in mind also. We were actually looking for this to be more of a joint effort, kind of to sit down with everybody and go, okay, this is our proposal. is there anything that you guys were looking at differently? Is there anything you guys wanted in a certain space differently? And then we can kind of go back and forth on that and have a lot more dialogue, opposed to having something that's black and white, you know, and go, okay, there's a lot of gray in this. And we want to make sure that, you know, we're part of the city here. We don't want to ruffle any feathers. We want to be kind of conjoined with the city, not going back and forth against the city. That's the tension.
Mr. Pledge.
Just also to address some of the social media issues, there was a reference that this contract was written by the Croatian Center to favor them. This contract is pretty much a standard contract that we use, that the city has used, that we've used this before. Most recently, we used it with the Willoughby's Public Library to take over the use of the one end of City Hall. So just to make it clear and put it on the record, the Croatian Lodge and their attorneys did not draft this lease at all. It's been a mutual document that the city has had ample opportunity to review and to have input on, as has the Croatian Lodge. We should have had more input and opportunity to review it, as they're not the drafters. So I wanted to clear that up on the record as well.
Mr. Gately.
Mayor, this question for you. If this does move forward, when it comes to the drawings, I know that Marco mentions that, you know, it would be, with us and everything. Would that be, would the decisions be made as far as what goes in there and how things get laid out strictly, like with maybe yourself and the service director? Or would that be something that could be moved over to, like, the recreation committee? Or
I have no issue with it going to the recreation committee.
I mean, it wouldn't be to hold anything up. You wouldn't want to hold anything up. I'm just wondering if there was any, like, if you wanted to do a design or do something that we would have some kind of input.
Mr. Pledge.
Just not to step on your toes there, Marco, but I think if whatever they're going to do, depending on the significance of it, it's going to have to come through the building department. If they're going to put up a gazebo, they're going to have to get a permit for it. So we're always going to have input to look and see what they're doing and how the design is. And if we don't like something, you know, we're going to work together. I see him coming to the table as a partner.
That's what I'm...
You know, so...
I agree.
But again, they're still going to have to follow all the same ordinances that everybody in the city follows. And if they're going to put any type of development there or change drainage, they're going to be in here talking to the building director. And we're going to make sure things are done properly and that, you know, the residents are protected, none of their property is damaged, and that it's used for a proper purpose.
Yeah, I see this as being multiple.
Marco.
I'm sorry.
Marco, go ahead. When we record the meeting, she doesn't know who's who, so
okay.
I need to say her name so she recognizes.
While we're doing the drawings, I'm assuming that there's going to be multiple revision levels, and prior to even giving the green light on our end to proceed with this, there's obviously going to be appraisals and budgets and bids that are going to be proposed, and who's going to be doing the work and the scope. And you know, if this comes out to be a lot higher than what we anticipated, it still gives us the flexibility to walk away from this to say it's, you know, this is kind of, it's become too much for us to invest in. So
Mr. Myers?
Good.
Mr. Spahn?
Okay. I'm fine.
I'm looking through the lease, more directed towards the mayor. I know that the panel had requested a section in there about parking. So we took it out and we came back and said that, you know, we'd be going to work with them as long as they have the written consent. Is that, I don't see that back in the lease.
Yeah, well, their plans, and Mark and I talked today, their plans are not to use our parking lot at all.
Not to use
the
parking lot at all?
There's something on roads they've talked to you, but other than that,
yeah, it would be great to have the flexibility to work with you on if it's a crazy weekend for some written consent. However, you know, for us, it's in our best interest to use our parking lot for our local businesses, for our restaurant, for our banquet, to drive more traffic through there. I would love for them to park at our place as opposed to your parking lot. It just makes business sense.
I have no other questions. Anybody else? Good. Okay. At this point, we have nothing under miscellaneous. I would like to jump into recognition of the public. caution everybody, please do recognize, state your name and address. All comments will not include personalities, and all comments will be directed towards the chair.
Okay.
With that, I will open it up to public. We have set aside a half hour, 3 minutes per person. If we have to go a little longer, there will be no problem. Anybody wishing? Nobody? Nobody? Name and address.
I'll tell your bike. Angelo Trevisano, 34186 Waldmer Drive. I just want to first thank everyone. I think that the question and answer session was really helpful because there were a lot of questions. It sounds like, just based on some of the comments that were made, there were questions that I haven't even seen. I mean, we keep mentioning social media. Apparently there was something that even we didn't see. So that was very helpful. So I think, you know, all of us are, all the residents that are here that aren't part of council or part of the lodge are thankful that you were able to come by and answer some of these questions. Because I know that a lot of questions and comments have been thrown out there. I guess just the first comment I would like to make is that all of the documentation, all the leases, and all the letters and any comments, for anyone that happens to be reading these minutes after the meeting, are going to be on eastlakedata.org in case anyone wants to look at them later. The second question or comment I had was... The Croatia Juniors, that's the nonprofit organization?
Correct.
And I think that's a letter was sent to the city administration that it is a 501c3. Mm-hmm. Do you know if it's still a 501c3? I tried to look it up and didn't see it on the IRS website. And then another document that was also included, it shows a list of all the Eastlake nonprofits. And Croatia Juniors wasn't on that list. I figured maybe it was an older list, so I double-checked it, and it still isn't showing up. So I know you said you weren't on the board of directors of that organization, so maybe you don't know for sure, but I guess... It's just kind of a still a loose end. You know, this lease is not with a nonprofit, and I don't want to get like hung up on that fact, but it's just
the mayor, either one of you can answer that question as to 501c3 because I have seen the documentation.
This should have been in the record request you asked.
Yeah. I have it. Yeah.
And it shows the Croatian. American Heritage Foundation, Art Croatia, and then this one here, the September 15, 501c3, with their group that we talked about.
Okay.
So that's what they were giving to me, Croatia Juniors, Inc.
Okay.
So I don't know why, you know, agreed. I don't know if it's just not on here, but this is the document that's signed off by the federal government.
So there's potentially at least three nonprofits that will use this, not just one. It's not just one soccer organization.
Yeah, this is to the IRS. This one, the last one.
Okay. All right. Just in the email, it said Croatia Juniors.
Did you get this part on the
first page?
Is that on there?
But that's from September 2015.
Yeah. State your name, please.
Sorry.
I got that part too, yeah. I guess I just didn't know if you were trying to show that Croatia Juniors was a nonprofit.
Yeah,
but
that's
I guess
why
the alternative explanation is that there's three organizations that might be using it. Okay. And then I guess because we don't. No, if it's a glitch with the IRS, I mean, maybe it's just a glitch or something.
You work for the federal government.
I work for the federal government. Yeah, I didn't see it.
The easiest way to answer that question, is there an EIN number on that form?
There is. Yes.
And the date on the form?
September 29, 2015.
Okay. They are legitimate. They have been issued a state ID.
What do you say?
EIN.
Yeah.
Under the 501c3, they have to have that. It has to be recognized by the state. It has to be recognized by the federal.
Right. It's not an important point, ultimately.
Well, it sort of is, because on social media, it's continually saying that they're not nonprofit. And, again, I'm good with, and I've told you both, I'm good with social media. But when there's things on there and then I'm getting phone calls or he's getting phone calls saying the opposite because social media said they're not nonprofit, then it is an issue, so.
That needs to be fixed.
It needs to be fixed.
So.
Anybody else? Yes.
Jessica Trevisano, 34186 Waldemar Drive. So I don't think it's inaccurate, and even Marco said it's not inaccurate to say that the lease is between a for-profit entity and the city. Even though a nonprofit is going to be making use of the field, it's still a for-profit entity. That's like if you had a lease with like Walmart, and then Walmart said, don't worry, it's our nonprofit arm that's going to use it. I don't think it's an inaccurate statement to say that the lease is between.
I think that you come to the meetings and you understand the rest because you hear everything.
Right.
But what's on social media, people just run with it. And that's the problem sometimes. So.
Who's seen it on social media?
Anybody else?
Chris Kroniak, 1278 Waverly Road. I haven't heard anything about that. That's the first I'm hearing of it. But it's a very good point.
It's not on Facebook. It's on a difference.
Yeah, it's a very good point, though. I mean, I think the thing that we've seen, and Marco, you're on my page as well, I think the thing that we've seen is a lot of people saying, why only $1? If, in fact, we are, as we've done with EPAL and the Y, giving to nonprofit organizations, say, okay, in light of this, you know, wonderful sharing, we'll charge you a dollar. But these are not for-profit entities. So, no, I am grateful. I think it's fantastic that you're assuring us that to keep the original park-like setting to which Central Park was originally designed for is reassuring for some residents. I mean, we don't want to see that lost. There's a feeling of giving away green space and getting nothing in return. My also concern is in 15 years, while it's a wonderful thought to say in 15 years we may be in a better place and certainly we could do something with it, sure, what happens if we're in a worse place, something goes wrong, you guys back out, now we have a $250,000 fields back there, we can't take care of the fields that we have now, now we're stuck with all of the landlocked space back there and can't take care of it. So, and the only place to get to it would be from your property. So, I think those are concerns for people. I worry, well, I think one good question that was brought up was about stormwater easement. All property owners are required to pay stormwater assessment to the county, and this is only a dollar a year that we're going to be charging you, so who's going to be eating that? I'm assuming the city.
We have to pay it regardless. We pay it now.
So, but this isn't something that could be built in that is their cost.
Well, I guess we could look at that. I mean, I think it was, what, $250?
A year? A month?
Something like that.
Something? I don't know how they bill it.
I mean, we had, we're paying for the one at the Y.
Does EPAL pay?
I'm sorry?
Does EPAL pay the stormwater?
No, they do not.
Okay, so the city is paying for that one as well.
That is being looked into at this time.
I mean, it's the way we're looking at it, it's our property, so we're paying for it. I guess from my end is what I've said is they're putting in the improvements, whatever. It's $250,000, $100,000. That's the way I look at it. Instead of the dollar, I think Laura had something that she said it shows like it's $1,700 a year or whatever. It's about, from my end and our end, is that we're going to have something that we can be proud of. I mean,
sure.
We've gone through the thing in Jackson,
absolutely.
You're well aware, and we're just trying to do that in a different part of the city.
Right.
I mean, I can't, say that any clearer that I wish we could do the drawing that you sent over to us. I wish we could do that, but this drawing, where'd it go? This drawing is not free. This drawing is not free to maintain. So, but if we had the money, then obviously we'd have different parks. But again, we're just trying to do things, and I think we've done a good job over the last so many years of having people pay for everything that we don't want to pay for, with the pool and with the EPAL and possibly this. And I think that's what I think the big picture sometimes everyone misses at. We don't want to do something, but the alternative is we're trying to get it where everyone else is paying stuff for us, and we've gotten that done, and I'm good with the banter and the people's concerns. We're here to do what's best for the city. myself, the seven of them, and the directors here. And that's all I can say on that. I mean, it's been my goal and it will continue to be the goal that we can do the best with, for our residents.
Okay. Jessica Trevisano, do you want me to restate my address? 34186 Waldmore Drive. So the way I see it is that council really has two choices. You can either vote for this park and maybe have an aesthetically pretty space, but one that isn't open to the residents, that residents can't freely use. Or
I think we've clarified that.
I don't think
we stated very clearly that this park will be open to the residents. There will be a walkway through there. There will be a pavilion area. Correct me if I'm wrong, Marco.
That's an intention, but at the same time, we're very reluctant to sublease this out or allow the football team or somebody else to use it from an actual field standpoint. We are very concerned that we're going to, the American-Croatian Lodge will put a huge investment into a piece of property that is not ours, and then it'll be demolished by something that we don't have control over. It is essentially protecting our investment. We've stated before, we would love to have the Eastlake Rec, you know, come over by us. We would love to figure out what the cost is to run the whole thing and rent it out for whatever cost is, just to absorb the cost. We would love to have more Eastlake kids in our group. So essentially it drives our costs down for our entire program. We would love to grow the group. However, no, we're not open to allowing, you know, Eastlake rugby team to use the fields. No.
And
that's the intention.
And I think so. if you were buying that property, then that would be wonderful and fine and like a great business negotiation and a good deal for the city if they were buying the property. But it's city-owned land that I think those fields should be accessible to the EPAL kids who want to play on the land or to the kids who live at Dover Place or anybody who wants to just freely go over and use those fields. So I think your choice is really between aesthetic soccer fields that look nice and will hopefully look nice in 15 years or 20 years when we get them, or keeping that land open and accessible to the public. And those are just two values that you are going to have to weigh as council.
And I can completely understand what you're saying.
Address,
sorry, Chris Kranyak, 1278 Waverly Road. I can completely understand that. I'm on the fence with it. I get why you would not want people. I understand that those fields have irrigation, that they're mounded up so that the water drains off. You put a lot of money, a lot of time and effort into them. They're far superior than the fields over by, you know, at First Energy. So I understand why they would not allow that. I do. I don't think anybody just allows anyone to use EPAL. EPAL has specific jurisdiction over their property, and the same with the Y. I understand that. In Section 9B, which is where you all first started off, it says tenant agrees that good faith efforts shall be made to accommodate youth soccer leagues affiliated with the landlord. What specifically would you have in mind? Like, say, Eastlake has a soccer tournament, at the end of the year soccer tournament. If it was feasible, they could use the fields. Is that what you're talking about, or are you talking about why specifically was that put in there if you are not open to or amenable to having soccer play there, our soccer leagues play there?
I don't quite understand the question. I mean, it wasn't quite clear what you just stated, because we are open to having Eastlake soccer programs there. That's the intention. But at what cost?
Okay, so you are amenable to having soccer play.
I mean, it's going to cost us at the end of the year $20,000 to maintain the
fields. Okay.
That's every year cutting, fertilizing, lining them up, doing everything that's necessary. So, and it's going to be only used for 25, 30 weeks out of the year.
Right.
And so when we do the math, it's, you know, whatever it is, $700, $800 a weekend. So would we be willing to give it to the small kids at that cost for the weekend for a small tournament? Of course, the wear and tear is minimal.
Right.
You know, of course we would be. You know, we have no intention of charging a premium for something like that. We're also looking at revising some of our internal group to say, okay, if they're Eastlake residents, let's give them a discount on our program to give them incentive to grow the program. And hey, look, this is a part of their property that they're paying for anyway. So,
right.
You know, we're trying to come to the table with solutions. Nothing is set in stone. Please keep that in mind.
Right.
So we're trying to come up and work with different options and things that we can do.
Yeah.
Anybody else?
Angelo Trevisano, 34186 Waldmer Drive. I guess just the only other comment I had was I didn't know that those fields were only vacant for 2 years. Is that correct? 2 years?
And approximately 2 years.
Two years. The last time I was over around there, I mean, it looks like they've been vacant for much, much longer than that. I was thinking at least like 10, 20 years. But the fact that it's only been 2 years, it just seems like a very, very short time to just immediately let go of it. I could see if it would, you know, if there were just trees already growing back, you know, but 2 years just seems, I mean, I would love to, as I've written in my letter to council, I would love to see that property be made into a proper park that all residents can use, that all residents can enjoy. And if that can't happen, then I think that the Lodge's soccer facility plan is like a really good alternative. But I think a public park that could be used would be better. And I think while it's been stated that, you know, we don't have the money, we also, it doesn't, at least to my knowledge, haven't applied for any grants. Have we contacted any companies like we did with Best Supply for the pool, the county for the $75,000 grant for pool additions? I mentioned the Fraternity of Eagles, who recently moved into Dubingo. They expressed in public meetings that they were looking to contribute to the city of Eastlake and its organizations. So I guess just that just really stuck out to me. It's only been 2 years. You know, and I know that you need to make your moves. You know, you know, money is a thing. And
let me answer a couple of your questions. I've contacted Pepsi. I've contacted Coca-Cola. No interest. None. Not even as a sponsor. None of the leagues in this city want anything to do with that property. The city cannot maintain that property anymore. You see the condition it's in right now. You thought it had been closed 10 years. It's only been two. How's it going to look in another year? Okay. The fencing in that area is becoming a safety hazard. The fencing is falling over. Okay. $8,000 to $10,000 just to replace the fencing. Just to replace the fencing. To repair or replace. EPAL look at it. We can't afford it. We can't. To answer your question, yes. Corporate sponsors have been looked at. Grants, I have not personally looked at any grants to maintain that property. I can't speak for the city, I'm sure they have. Thing to remember about grants is, for every one grant you find, how many people or cities do you think are applying for that grant? So. Anybody else?
I can kind of understand what you're talking about. I'm sorry, Chris Kroniak, 1278 Waverly Road. I can understand what you're talking about. I was kind of shocked that only 2 years, and I understand the state of it after 2 years is pretty decrepit and blighted, but it has been 2 years. I was shocked to understand that we still have a boys baseball league that plays at different fields. You know, I don't know if anyone's approached the boys baseball league to see if they could get them back over to there. Or even adult softball leagues. There's a lot of private adult softball leagues. I don't know. I'm kind of on the fence with it. You guys have answered quite a few things. Some people had questions of numbers in the parcels being switched with letters, and that's just semantics. You guys can fix that. No issue with that. The thing that I'm really pleased with that I hear you saying is that you're willing to work with the park and the surroundings if, in fact, you do. This does go through and you get those soccer fields, that you're willing to keep up the integrity of the park and have the green space still be there and have it be accessible to the residents. I think that was really, really important. The only other question that I had is, does the city have any intention of sending letters to any of the residences that abut those parcels to notify them that there is going to be construction, that there may be noise there when there are soccer games, that type of thing?
I don't have an issue with us doing that. I think what I, with noise or whatever after the construction, is it's always been a park, so I would hope the residents that live there know that already, but yeah, I don't have an issue sending out any letters to anyone.
I just wasn't sure if that was something that you guys did or thought about.
The thing with the leagues, and right now, because I had to ask the law director for a decision, Nick and I just went into the building back there, and we've been trying to get a hold of softball, and no one's responding. We're actually getting ready to sticker it and say the belongings are going to be the city of Eastlake here shortly, and possibly put it in the newspaper to say if someone doesn't step forward to come and get it, the contents are ours. And the pavilion that we talked about is the pavilion back there and the old area where they sold candy and gum and everything out of, is what we've talked about with them, that they would improve and make it a very nice place for our residents to go to during that. As most of you know, the fields aren't used at all there right now, and that's why they are. You know, my intentions will be, the city's intentions will be, if this doesn't go, we're just going to have to find time to start taking all the fencing down. Right. And then when we take all the fencing down, whoever does or the city has to come back and try to make them fields again, there's going to be a major cost. But again, as Mr. Evers said, the fencing's falling down. I can't have someone get hurt, so we're going to start probably start tearing fencing down ourselves as time permits. But again, I tell everyone that's contact me, just at least walk back there and tell me what you think. Like I said, I don't, maybe I shouldn't have used the word blighted in my first time because I had offended some people, but, I'm embarrassed of it too. I was embarrassed as a councilman, embarrassed as the mayor of some of our areas. We're just trying to make do with working on outside entities, and this is a good group. They're a big part of our city.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, that Croatian Lodge and the things that I've dealt with as a councilman and is now, they want the best for our city. If you saw the article, a month ago, about the improvements they've done over there, they're planning on staying here. We just, I'm not saying you just say, hey, everything, because we need you to stay here, but we need to work with them. And that's all these meetings are intended for. And again, this is what these meetings are for. And I'm glad we have some people that came out, because the keyboard strokes drive me crazy when people send me links and things of everything that's going on out there, and I just shake my head. It's like you come here and you hear everything, and it still can go out and be portrayed how the meeting went, but this is what I would love, that this room's filled, but it never is. It's just, it is what it is. You know what? And I've said this before, the four new people and the three, they're working hard for this city, and I know some people think we're not, but they are. I give them the utmost credit, especially the four new ones. You know, their first thing that they passed was they're not taking the raise that we haven't taken for the last three times, which is not a ton of money, but it's still, if you add it up, it would be another $1,800, and they're the lowest council in the area. But again, they're not in it for the money. Obviously, I'm not in it for the money. So,
one at a time.
Jessica Trevisano, 34186 Waldmore Drive. I have three questions. Hopefully they're pretty quick. The first is, maybe you guys don't know, but is there a reason that the ACL doesn't have sidewalks in front of the building?
What's that got to do with this meeting?
Well, if the ACL keeps saying that they want to improve the public, be, you know, helpful to the public, I think that the fact that for some reason theirs is one of the very few buildings on Lakeshore that doesn't have sidewalks.
I'm sorry, I find that question to be impertinent to this finance meeting about the lease for the soccer fields.
I will move on then.
That is a question you could direct to them at another time.
Okay, I'll move on to my second question. In the lease, it doesn't say when the improvements are due. Is that something that council might consider putting into the lease? So there's no, like, in 1 year, in 2 years, in 15 years, when the soccer fields would need to be built.
I think, if this would go through, their plans aren't that we're going to build something. They're planning on just doing it once this is passed.
Right.
If we could put a time frame in, if that would make people happy, do you have an issue with time frame?
Can I just say something?
Your name was?
Yeah, Ante Slavic. I'm also a member of the Croatian Lives Board of Directors. I'm going to mostly dealt with Marco, but this is something, going back to your point, I don't know the best way to put this, but we're not, if you look at our group in general, American-Croatian Lodge, and what we're structured, we have an immediate need now for these fields. So not something we're looking to do 5 years, 10 years. We're looking to do this tomorrow in our Chardon location. Now, the opportunity is there to stay in Eastlake. We've been here for 30 years. I was born here. Most of our members, our shareholders, whoever it be, live in Eastlake currently. So we saw the opportunity next door to this park, this field that's fallen apart, that really, one, for us as a business being next door, it's an eyesore. Two, we have an immediate need for it. Now, you go back, nonprofit, this, that, whatever it may be. Yes, the Croatian Lodge itself is a for-profit, and we are a business, but we're not doing this as a business deal for us. We built that additional building, 10 years ago? I don't know how familiar you guys are. We leased the bottom half. The upstairs is donated to a Croatian school, a couple different Tamaritsan organizations, multiple are nonprofits. That was the purpose we built. We didn't build that for ourselves. We put the space downstairs, hopefully, to pay cover costs so it doesn't come out of our pocket every year. Same idea with these fields. It's going to be for Croatian soccer fields. And now you guys have concerns. The city of Eastlake, again, Marco said it, we're vested with the city. We're not going anywhere. We would prefer not to go to Chardon. But the deal has to make sense. So just kind of put my sense, maybe a different perspective, or to hear someone else's opinion. But you guys are absolutely right. We are here for the long haul. Marco and I sit on his board of directors. We're not paid either. This is all volunteer. We do this on the good of our heart for our community. We were, raised within the Croatian community, within Eastlake. I spent half my childhood in that lodge. So this is something we want to continue, not only for my kids, but their kids and so on. So for us to ensure the next 15 to 20 years, not only for the lodge, but for the Croatian Soccer Club, is huge for us. But again, time is of the essence. Mark said it, we have other opportunities. Maybe they're not the best, but it's a option.
Right.
The youth program is growing. We need to address it.
I just had one last question. And I think that's great. And my concern with the timing is just it's not in the lease, so there's nothing sure. Holding you to it.
And I don't think we would be opposed to some sort of timeline if the deal's made.
Right. My last question was, I was a little unclear in the lease when the improvements become the property of the cities. If it was, as soon as the improvements are added to the premises, they belong to the city technically, or if it's at the termination of the lease. That was just a question.
I have different thought to Randy.
I don't believe that we're going to take the grass up after the lease is over.
Fencing or anything like that.
I don't
know. But from a legal standpoint, I would let the lawyers deal with that one.
Okay.
Missed the pledge.
So you're saying if this lease is approved, it's your intent to start work right away?
Would want to get architectural drawings right away and then propose it to you and go back and forth and then start getting bids on it.
Would it be something that you would want to have done for this season or next season? I'm just asking what you're
Ideally, it would be great to have it being finished by the fall. Ideally, okay. But understanding how grass grows, we might have to hold off another full year and not play on it or do anything, and actually that we would absorb that cost for 1 year and not use it.
Okay.
So.
And then just as an attorney, I would know that does. Structured improvements that are embedded in the ground become fixtures, and they would revert back to the city. So, but we can double check that with our law director just to be sure.
Sorry, can I just do one more question?
It'll be the last question.
Chris Kroniak, 1278. Just to extrapolate on what she was saying, I believe the property that is around, not just the fields. When would that be made available? When does that actually become the city of East Lakes? So even though the property around it, am I understanding that that's something, when you guys improve the property around it, whether it's a bike path or whether it's just a playground area, is that still city-owned property?
It's always going to be our property.
Okay. All right. So that part.
Yeah, we're not giving any property up.
Right.
It's the parcels will still be in our name. Everything's going to be the same.
And I guess the final question is, how much and why did $1 come up?
$1 I look at because I look at the way with the leases and saying they're putting the improvements in.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't want to say give us, like we do with the library, give us so much money a month. The library's not making any improvements. They're just leasing the building from us. Here they're making improvements. That's where the dollar came from. Same with the Willoughby's Lake. I mean, like us with the senior center. Willoughby's Lake School charges us $1. First Energy charges us $1 for the corner.
Right.
First Energy charges us $1 for the seawall. So that's where we came up with it. It's just we didn't come up with a nominal fee. Say we're going to charge rent and you're going to put the improvements in.
As a round number, if they do a 15-year lease, if they put $250,000 into it, and those are the numbers that we've talked about tonight, that comes down to almost just under $1,400 a month in rental income. Like that, that's their investment back in the community. So, just for a number there, just if you're looking at financing, so actually $1,388 is the number a month. That's how we would look at their investment.
Does that include the general maintenance, or that would
no,
be
no, that's
cost,
just the
yeah.
that's just your $250 number,
the,
not the $20,000 a year on top of that. So it's even more money that they're putting into the city.
When can we have a final contract with corrections?
I mean, I'll talk. We'll talk, and I have the lawyers talk. And what do you need from the wall director?
What corrections?
Well,
the number? The parcel
numbers? The parcel numbers should be corrected. I don't know. Was there anything else that was issued that needs to be into this contract? All questions I thought were answered fairly thoroughly.
The only thing I would say as far as corrections to the lease is the A and Bs are inaccurate. Just as far as you're talking about subsections. Under section 5, it's section A, B, B.
Can you send your notes to the wall director, please?
Pardon?
You said with the law director?
Yeah, I'll talk to you. Actually, this is the old one. It's not the one that I came up with.
The newest one is the one I emailed you. The one that they put in your box. I don't know.
Yeah.
Like I said, just toss it.
Right. I'll send them a message just to double check the numbering, section numbering, the lettering, so that it's clear.
Okay. At this point, I'm going to pull the committee either to move forward or hold it in committee. Mr. Zern.
I say to move forward. I think it's a big commitment by one of the biggest partners of our city. They're putting all the money in to improve the property, which is not being used by any sports organizations at this time. No cost to the city. And allowing Eastlake Soccer, working with Eastlake Soccer, to use the facilities, I think is a win-win for the city and the and Croatian Lodge.
Mr. Hayden.
I would prefer same sentiment. I'd say we can move this forward. I think it's a win-win with the city. I mean, you guys have been here a long time, and I have no problem with it. Yeah.
I'm going to say move forward. I know we'll get the corrections on the contract. This committee will move this forward to council so that the public understands. There was no vote taken here tonight to approve the contract. All we did was move it forward out of the committee and move it over to council for their vote. Okay. With that, I'm going to adjourn this meeting at 7:07 p.m.
Thank you guys for coming.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you, Marco.